Welcome again to HopeSide Vespers. Today is October 21, 2022. It was quite challenging to go through the week for many, but also today there was nice weather over here. It is getting colder as we go through the remaining days of 2022. So we thank God for keeping us safe, no matter what the difficulties may be. And so this is the fourth week of October. There are 5 weeks in this month. And the fourth week is focused of any month on outreach or evangelism. And here is a quote for you to consider. It says, a Christian without purpose is a Christian who doesn't win souls. This is by Bishop, I cannot read the name here, but I will read it again. A Christian without purpose is a Christian who doesn't win souls. And that is very true, because the commission is that we go and make disciples. We teach and we preach. We live exemplary lives so that we can win souls. Thank you all again for joining. And so the opening song is called Mine Eyes Have Seen the Glory.
Is true, is watching.
We will have the opening prayer by Mr. Joseph Kelly Padapudi.
Let's pray. Loving Lord, Eternal Father, the creator of this universe, you have given us the Sabbath to praise you, uphold your name, and it is our privilege to thank you. And not only that, it is our privilege to be called as children of you, Father. We are not worthy to be called as your children, but you came and died on the cross of Calvary and given us the freedom to be the children of thee. At this moment, Father, we are praying for the families who are here. We're worshiping with everyone, bless each family. Every family have some health issues, difficult times, but yet, please take care of everybody's problems, Father. I'm praying for Prashant Patta and Sujit Chinta and Fancy Akas and Vilasini Akas, mother, please help these three people, heal them with their problems, Father. Everybody having some kind of ailments in their life, but yet you are protecting everyone and bringing them to this Friday evening for Sabbath hours. And I want to pray for the preacher of this hour, Mr. Pastor Vara Prasad. Take care of him, touch his lips, and give him the Holy Spirit. Whatever comes out of his mouth, acceptable in thy sight, Father. Bless each one of us. Forgive us in our shortcomings. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. We will have the scripture reading by Mrs. Premala Padapudi.
Our scripture meditation this evening is taken from Acts chapter 4, verse 12. The book of Acts chapter 4, verse 12, and I'm reading from King James Version. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is none other name under the heaven given among men, whereby we must be saved. Amen, and may God bless the word that has been read.
Thank you. Now, I would like to let you all know that today is a special day for at least two people who are right here in our Vespers. That is Premala, who's celebrating her birthday, which she shares with her late father, Dr. K.J. Moses. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Premala for all that she has been doing to enhance and enrich and expand the ministry of HopeSide through women's participation. And she has, of course, a great family, and they're all blessed in many ways, and also with grandchildren now. Of course, I know her since high school, as I said that before.
Right.
And I wish I also got married very young, you know, and maybe I would have had children like that. So they're a blessed family. They have been a blessing to so many, through her sister, through brothers, and so on. So Premala, thank you, and happy birthday to you, and may God bless you.
Thank you.
And also, of course, the speaker for today, who is no stranger to us, that is Dr. Vara Prasad, Deepati, who is my cousin. And I would like to wish him happy birthday, a blessed birthday. May God bless you in everything that you're going to undertake in the future with a greater responsibility that has been given to you. And may God bless you as you lead out in the ministerial department of Southern Asia Division. That is India and three other countries. And so a special song has been selected to play to wish especially these two happy birthday. Hope you'll find it enjoyable. Have a special birthday prayer by Mr. Ratan Raj.
Okay, thank you, Anand. By the way, I know Pramila before she was born. I remember our parents just getting married and came to Narsapur, and eventually they became as a teacher and an accountant. And I think, Pramila, weren't you born in Nuzweed or in Narsapur?
I was born in Elur, uncle.
Elur, uncle, yes. Elur. And you was a little girl. And you came to Narsapur.
Right.
And Vara Prasad, I know Vara Prasad very recently, but I know his parents, Mr. D. John Prasad Ravanya. We all studied together, worked in a printing press in Narsapur, and his wife happened to be the sister of my dear friend, Anand Raj, C.H. Anand Raj. And he's a very accomplished man, and we are glad that we are able to celebrate your birthday. So let's pray. Our Eternal Father, we gathered here virtually once again as members and friends of the HopeSide Church at this Vespers hour to worship you and praise your mercies that are innumerable. Thank you for keeping each of us safe and making it possible for us to come into your presence to sing songs of praise and to hear the message from your word that is a light unto our path. May the message that your servant Vara Prasad brings encourage and motivate us to be your faithful children. Lord, we have come short of your glory many times, and I pray that you will forgive us. This evening, we specially pray for Pramila Pedapudi and Vara Prasad Deepati, who are celebrating their birthdays this month. As they celebrate the life that God has given them, may they continue to be a blessing to their families and above all to you, O Lord. They mean so much to us in this worship service. Please grant them your mercy and grace and grant them abundant blessings as they serve you. We pray that you bless this service and the HopeSide Church as they continue to be a light in this community is my prayer in your holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Mr. Ratan Raj, for that wonderful prayer. The speaker, Dr. Vara Prasad Deepati, has been introduced many times. And so we know him. We know his ministry. We know his family. And in all the ways he has progressed in his life, even since childhood, I know him. I've seen how he has strived and worked hard, and God has rewarded him in many different ways, despite all the challenges that we also face in our lives. And so we're glad that he is appointed to be the head of the ministerial department in Southern Asia Division. And so as he takes up that role, let us continue to remember and pray and support him in whatever way that's possible. I don't know anything that is happening, which is the latest. And so maybe Dr. Vara Prasad can share if there's anything that has progressed or changed in terms of his taking up this role since the last time he spoke to us. And so, here is Dr. Vara Prasad.
Thank you. Thank you, Elder Anand. Thank you so very much. I hope I'm audible. Something is happening here.
Yes, you are audible.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for the birthday song. It's nice to know that somebody is wishing you all the best and also praying. Thank you very much for the song and the prayer also. Yeah, it's not too many days in this month that my birthday was celebrated. But I would like to wish Sister Pramila happy birthday and God bless you as we continue to serve the Lord and do our very part to hasten the coming of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God bless you with good health, stronger faith, and greater joy in service. Thank you also, Elder Anand, for the kind words of introduction. Right now in the division, people are busy with union constituencies, and we will have ECIU union constituency in the month of January. That is 2023. But as of now, this weekend, Union Constituency is happening for the Northern India Union. And we have other unions following in November and December as well. I would like to also thank you for consistently praying for my nephew, Prashant. As some of you may know, he is still in Vellore, recovering from the surgery, but also he is waiting for the chemotherapy that will begin on Monday. Young as he is, yes, all of us were very concerned, and it is only God who is sustaining him, and we thank each of you and many others who are praying for him. I spoke to my sister yesterday, and everything is set by God's grace for chemo to begin either Monday or Tuesday. I know this is another long process, and we ask of you to continue to pray for him, that body will accept, and by God's grace, he will go through this process without much difficulty. I heard of a death on our campus last night. We could not visit the family yet, but a person who is, I mean, the wife is working in the hospital, auxiliary staff, and we heard that he passed away while he was on the road. So the wife is Bindu. We want to whisper a prayer for her and for the family as well. Things are happening like this, and we know that Christ's coming is soon, and that is only, that is the best consolation that we have. In fact, the best hope that we have, that soon Jesus will put an end to all sin and suffering, and allow us to live in a place where there is no crying, and where there is no pain and sorrow, in fact, the diseases as well. So let us continue to do our very best to hasten the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we are reminded this week as HopeSide that we are involved in the outreach. Yes, we have our plans in our own ways as to how we reach people, but let's not forget that the best of all outreaches is a personal testimony. People seeing us, listening to us, and the way that we conduct ourselves, may that be an inspiration for people to follow Jesus Christ. Okay, having said that, the topic that we have for today is a joy of, what is that you have on your screen? Let me share the screen. Yes, the joy of heaven, joy of heaven. This topic I've chosen, in fact, I received from a song that is very familiar, and we will see that song, and we will make some points as to how the author has used the phrase, the joy of heaven, in her song. And as we move along, let's pray that God will continue to impress upon us by His Spirit the power of the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you so very much, Lord, that you have given us this opportunity once again to call upon your name, to study your word, but also, Father, to worship you. May our worship be acceptable unto you, Heavenly Father. And that, Lord, you will descend upon us by your Spirit, empower us not only that we remember as to how you have chosen us and to serve you in these last days, but also, Father, our faith in you will be strengthened, our joy in you will be multiplied as well. Thank you very much, Lord, that you will do this and even much more than we have asked or imagined. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. So joy over heaven. I'm reading a song that is familiar. Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you. Take it then wherever you go. Take it wherever you go. The refrain, precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and a joy of heaven. This is where the title is taken from. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth, joy and heaven. The second stanza, take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations around you gather, breathe that holy name in prayer. Third, oh, the precious name of Jesus, how it thrills our souls with joy when his loving arms receive us and his songs our tongues employ. And the final stanza, at the name of Jesus, bowing, falling prostrate at his feet, King of kings in heaven will crown him when our journey is complete. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. It's a beautiful song, and this song is composed or written by a person called Lydia Odell Baxter, as some of you may know. The text was originally by Lydia Odell Baxter. She wrote it, who was born at Petersburg, New York, on September 8, 1809. As a young woman, she and her sister were converted by the preaching of a traveling Baptist missionary, Eben Tucker. A little while later, the two sisters were mainly responsible for the establishment of a Baptist church in their hometown. After her marriage, Lydia moved to New York City, New York, with her husband, where she zealously continued to carry on her religious work. Due to a serious illness, she became partial invalid and was confined to her bed much of the time, but her home was a gathering place for preachers and other religious workers who came to her for advice. So here we have a person on the bed, and people are gathering around her bed, and they are coming, yes, to pray for, but in a very special way, as we understand from this information, they were receiving advices from her. Though Lydia was simply a housewife, all who knew her said that her radiance was an inspiration to them. Her radiance was an inspiration to the people who visited her. Because of her patient cheerfulness, people often visited her sick room, not so much to comfort her as to be blessed by her. You know, as I was reading this, I was wondering what I am. I'm doing well by God's grace in health and otherwise. What am I? Am I a blessing to others? That is a question that I had as I was reading this. But praise the Lord, Lydia, despite being ill and despite being confined to bed, people were visiting her, not to just say a kind word or so, whatever, but they themselves experienced blessings of God. In 1855, she published a collection of religious poetry, Gems by the Wayside. Also, she produced a number of gospel songs, such as There is a Gate Ajar for Me, which were widely used. In 1870, she penned the Take the Name of Jesus with You. That was in 1870, while she was on a sick bed just 4 years before her death. Sick bed, groaning, mourning, feeling sorry for whatever it is. That is what usually we see people even today. But she wrote this wonderful song that is a blessing ever since. From 1870. This is one of our favorite songs, I believe, even as we worship God today. An avid student of the Bible, she often engaged in discussions of scriptural names with her friends and felt that the very utterance of the name of Jesus carried her to a deeper understanding, saying, when the tempter tries to make me blue or despondent, I mention the name of Jesus and he can't get through to me anymore. The name of Jesus, a name above every name, Jesus Christ. The tune, particularly of the refrain, was composed by William Howard Doane. That was between 1832 to 1915 as he lived. Mrs. Baxter, Lydia Baxter, who never permitted her physical ability to stop her active mind from studying God's word and writing about it or quench your spiritual joy, died in New York City on June 22, 1874, at the age of 65. Some time back, we reminded ourselves, a minister may die, but his or her ministry never dies. Paul writes about Abel in Hebrews 11. Though he were dead, he continues to speak. And that we see even in the life and the ministry of Lydia Baxter. This song, Take the Name of Jesus, became widely known in evangelical churches through its use in evangelistic campaigns during the latter 19th century by revivalist Dwight Lyman Moody, as we may popularly call him, D.L. Moody, and his music director, Ira David Sankey. It has become a very popular closing hymn. We talked about the song, Take the Name of Jesus With You. The song reminds us of the power of Jesus' name, which we should carry with us throughout life. Now about the song that we have in our hymnals. In stanza one, we are told that the name of Jesus will give us joy and peace. Nothing else. It's the name of Jesus which gives us joy and peace. We need to be reminded of ourselves every day, but I believe we also have the privilege and a blessing, and of course the mandate from Jesus Christ himself, to let the world know that Jesus, the name of Jesus, gives us joy and peace. This is lasting joy and lasting peace. You know, from Isaiah 9, that Jesus Christ is a Prince of Peace. And he said in John 14, that I give you my peace, not as the world gives, but Jesus is saying, I give my peace. The world will not be able to understand it, but praise the Lord, as people trust in Jesus, they can experience this joy and peace every moment of their lives, despite whatever is happening in life. Take the name of Jesus with you. This is the first answer. Child of sorrow and of woe, it will joy and comfort give you. Take it then wherever you go. We know that it is, the name of Jesus is not something tangible in the sense we cannot carry it as we carry a Bible or anything for that matter. But I believe the author is writing to us, reminding us of the power of Jesus Christ as we enter into relationship with him and stay in that relationship, that Jesus himself said, remain in me. So it will joy and comfort give you. Take it then wherever you go. Meaning never, never, even for a moment, think that you're alone, but Christ is with us always. So from the first stanza, we have these three insights given for us. As human beings, we are children of sorrow and woe, living in the context of sin, living in the context in which the devil is redoubling his efforts to destroy the faith of Jesus in us, but also destroy the work of Christ on Calvary. We are reminded that, we are children of sorrow and woe. Every moment, from every angle, we can see the devil trying to attack us and destroy our faith in God. And Job, for an example, we know that he was attacked by the devil. Just to remind ourselves, he lost his property, that includes children, and then he lost his health. He lost the support that he should receive from his dear wife, and also the loss of the support from the society, even as friends went to him. But the point is that Job remained faithful. Two things probably for a consideration this evening. Job knew that this world is not his home, and this world is full of sin and suffering. Even good people, meaning God-fearing people, will experience losses and even pain for that matter. He said that to his wife, and when his wife said, curse God and die, he said to her, don't you know, as a paraphrase, don't you know that we, yes, are blessed by God. Don't you know that good and evil happen to us as well. So, as human beings, yes, we are children of sorrow and woe, meaning the devil is attacking us in every way possible. But the name of Jesus brings joy and comfort, because it is through believing in his name that we have the right to become children of God. Praise the Lord. Yes, we don't have to remain as children of sorrow and woe. We can choose to become children of God. And in that relationship, we have this joy and comfort as our experience. As we continue this joy and comfort, we must take it wherever we go by following him, by following him. One invitation that Jesus gave, yes, we see very clearly in the lives of the disciples. He said to them, follow me. But we also want to remember that that invitation was given not just to these 12 people. Of course, they say that Judas was not invited, but Jesus Christ, Judas, went into this discipleship by his own, but Jesus Christ invited even this rich young ruler. You may remember what Jesus said to him in Matthew 19, where Jesus said, sell your property, give to the poor, and follow me. This is really, really beautiful. If Jesus said to him just to sell his property and give to the poor, I don't think we need Jesus Christ. But praise the Lord, same invitation that he gave to the disciples, Matthew, John, whoever it is, he gave that invitation to this rich young ruler. Meaning everyone in this world is given this invitation to follow Jesus Christ. That is to allow Jesus Christ to the supreme ruler, the Lord of our lives, every day in this world, but also to spend eternity with him. But the point is that we have this privilege and invitation from the Creator, Savior, and our friend Jesus Christ, that we enter into a relationship with him. Believing in his name, we have become the children of God. And to continue this joy and comfort, we must take it wherever we go by following him. We take it by following him. We take the name of Jesus wherever we go. Meaning people see Jesus in us. People will hear the voice of Jesus Christ even as we relate ourselves to with our human beings. They will be attracted by God's grace to follow Jesus Christ, to enjoy the same blessings that we keep enjoying as we serve him. But the point is, my friends, name of Jesus is not for us to keep for ourselves, but it is to take it wherever we go, meaning allowing people to see that we are special and God has a special plan and purpose for us. In stanza 2, we are told that the name of Jesus will serve as a shield from every snare. This is really, really beautiful. In Genesis 15 and verse 1, God said to Abraham, do not fear, I am your shield. Shield. Now, those of us who know the language of war or battle, we understand that shield comes between the enemy and ourselves. When God said to Abraham, I'm your shield, we want to remember, God is saying to Abraham, if someone has to attack you successfully first, that person has to attack me successfully. Meaning remove me and then that person will have to attack you. Taking words from Paul from Romans 8, we know, Paul said, if God be for us, who can be against us? So if God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, is a shield, no one can in fact touch us. No one can destroy us. No one can destroy our faith as well. Second stanza says, take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare, as a shield from every snare. Yes, we want to remember, it is not only that Jesus died on the cross for us 2,000 years ago, but he's in the business of protecting us from every snare of the devil even today. The promise that was made to Abraham was a human being, and so that promise is for every human being, that God is our shield, that he will protect us from every snare, every temptation and trial that may come to us as we live in this world. call it financial problems or whatever it is, diseases, accidents, misunderstandings, whatever it is, the Lord is able to protect us and in fact solve our problems and convert our problems into miracles. Take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations around you gather, breathe that holy name in prayer. Just, I mean, we know that prayer is like a breath, meaning we breathe in and breathe out. And wonderful it is to know that God is in the business of not only listening to words that we utter in prayer, but in fact operates in such a way that he gives us according to our heart's desires as well. Fulfills our heart's desires, as the psalmist says in 37th Psalm and verse 4. Breathe that holy name in prayer. He told our friends that we pray without ceasing. Paul says so in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, pray without ceasing. In other words, if we say that a prayer to God is like talking to him, God is saying to us, speak, continue to speak to me, continue to talk. In other words, God is promising us that he will listen to us without ceasing. This is the kind of God that we worship. This is the kind of God that we worship. He pays attention to every word that we utter. Yes. But praise the Lord that he notices everything that goes about us. Even the tears that we shed, we are told well and white, not even a single drop doesn't fall to our cheeks from our eyes without God allowing it to happen, without God noticing our pains and sorrows. So take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations around you gather, breathe that holy name in prayer. 3 points from second stanza. God promised to be a shield for us, for his people. We need a shield to protect us because temptations around us are gathered. There is no time in which the devil rests, particularly those of us who are serving the Lord. Even if we remember from Revelation 12 and 17, the devil is full of anger against those people who have the testimony of Jesus, but also keep the commandments of God. And we want to remember, friends, that the special target of the devil in these last days is this group of people, as we call the remnant group, described in Revelation 12 and 17. And if you consider yourself, if we consider ourselves as remnant people, we want to remember that the devil is after us. Why? Because by God's grace, it is this group which will decide the destiny of the devil, meaning total destruction of the devil. That happens only because of this group of people who keep the commandments of God and nullify the accusation against God that God's law is impossible to be kept. So no wonder the devil is very much present in Adventist homes, remnant homes, so also remnant church and in institutions. You should not be afraid, or you should not in fact be disturbed. Be disturbed. No, not even for a moment. Why God is allowing this to happen? Because God is showing to the universe by this group that despite their losses, whatever it is, despite their losses, they will continue to trust God. While there is no magic in simply uttering the name Jesus, when we truly confess his name, it can help us live a life that is pleasing to God. Taking just one phrase from Philippians 2, Paul invites us to have the mind of Jesus Christ. And if you say that these words are not simply written by Paul, but God himself has used Paul to write these words for us, promise that we have is that God will give us the mind of Christ. The mind of Christ. To be humble, to be joyful, to be grateful. And mind of Jesus, to live a life that is pleasing to God himself. Okay, as we move in the third stanza, we are told that the name of Jesus will enable us to rest in his loving arms. To rest in his loving arms. This word rest is so familiar as we study the Word of God, but Matthew 11:28, very popular verse, very well-known verse. Jesus Christ's invitation to the entire world, come to me, I will give you rest. This is restfulness. This is joyfulness. This is an experience of immeasurable joy and thankfulness to God. Rest in his loving arms. Oh, the precious name of Jesus, how it thrills our souls with joy when his loving arms receive us and his songs are tongues employ, and his songs are tongues employ. This is wonderful to know, friend, even on this Sabbath, that we have rest in our Lord Jesus Christ. And he takes us into his arms and he gives us an assurance that we will remain with him the rest of eternity. No one can snatch us from these powerful hands of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. No one. We will continue to have that peace and joy, rest in the loving arms of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is only in the Lord that we can find a true joy. Philippians 4:4, rejoice in the Lord always. Rejoice in the Lord always. And 1 Thessalonians 5:16, as we have referred to in that passage, Paul says, be joyful always. For a long time, I was looking at this concept or even this verse, rejoice in the Lord or be joyful always. I was looking at this concept as if it is an instruction or a suggestion or whatever it is, even a command for that matter. But just a few days ago, this dawned on me that we need to consider that the writings of human beings are actually God's word. So when God says, rejoice in the Lord or be joyful always, we want to remember, friends, it is not simply a command. It is much more than a command. It is the desire of God that we be happy. Even as we see in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, it's the desire of God, will of God. So in that context, we can understand that be joyful always, coming from God himself, the mouth of God itself. We understand that it is a benediction that the heavens pronounce upon us. It's a blessing of God that he puts upon us. It's a benediction of the heavens. Be joyful always. As we say to one another, and we say receive blessings, even as people pronounce blessings in the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but also in the name of the Father and the Holy Spirit. God bless you, they say. We understand that God is in the business of blessing, but we want to understand, friends, that when God says be joyful always, it is the desire of God. It is his benediction upon every person who would like to take this benediction and live a life that is pleasing to him. This is God's benediction. It's not simply a desire. It is God is pronouncing those blessings upon us. This joy is for those who seek a refuge in his loving arms. Seek refuge in his loving arms. It is a choice that we make to experience the joy in the midst of all kinds of storms in life. We see storms, we see problems, we see disturbances, and we see people insulting, whatever it is, as we serve the Lord, as we take this name to every place that we go. But this name, Jesus, provides protection. This name, Jesus, provides true joy. While it is good for his songs to employ our tongues, we must also remember that to have the blessings that come in the name of Jesus, we must make sure that we do all the things in his name or by his authority. The word name appears in the Bible so many times, in the Old Testament, also in the New Testament. I've had the privilege of studying this name, this word name in the Old Testament. And similar concepts we find in the New Testament as well. Yes, the word name, particularly when it comes with the words name of the Lord in the Old Testament or name of Jesus in the New Testament. Same concept. It's simple to understand. Yes, it connotes or implies a character of the person, but also we want to see that it is the authority of God himself. No power. Even the demonic forces that try to disturb our faith do not have that much power. Only Jesus Christ and his name. And by his name, we can enjoy not only overcoming the temptations of the devil, but also live a life of joy and thanksgiving. So Paul wrote for us in Colossians chapter 3, whatever you do, do in the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Whether it is speaking, whether it is entertaining a thought in our minds, or even getting involved in any activity for that matter, or relationships, by God's grace, we have that name, we have that authority, we have that power that we can experience and be blessed, but also be a blessing to one another. In stanza 4, the final stanza, we are told that the name of Jesus will make it possible to be with him in heaven. It is Jesus. It is in the name of Jesus who has saved us from all sin in this world, but also given us the assurance that we can be with him forever and ever. The songwriter writes here, at the name of Jesus bowing, falling prostrate at his feet, King of kings in heaven, will crown him. We will crown him when our journey is complete. Praise the Lord. Our journey, call it a sorrowful or pitiful, with all kinds of problems in this world, it is going to come to an end. This pain in this world will not continue to forever. This pain will not continue forever. You know, it's because of Jesus Christ, his shed blood on the cross. We know that this sin and pain will come to an end, and the rapid fulfillment of all the prophecies, particularly Matthew 24 and verse 14, the gospel of the kingdom shall be preached as a testimony to all nations, and the end will come. This prophecy is very rapidly fulfilling right before our eyes, and all of us by God's grace are involved in spreading the gospel, taking this name of Jesus wherever we go, and people are accepting Jesus Christ as a personal savior. By God's grace, in our own time, anytime soon, we will see Jesus Christ descend, and we will see him in the clouds, and we will hear him say, well done, good and faithful servant. But we want to remember, my friends, it is only because of Jesus and his name, the authority and power, we have the assurance of eternal life. At the name of Jesus bowing, as we bow to him, as we worship him, and as we allow him to be the Lord of our lives, every moment of our lives, and as we prostrate at his feet, meaning surrender ourselves completely to him, we will also have the privilege of worshiping him in the heaven itself. That is not for a day or two, but the rest of eternity. Praise the Lord. This painful journey is soon to complete. At judgment, every knee will bow before Jesus in submission. We understand this concept of every knee bowing and every tongue confessing and every eye seeing Jesus Christ. We understand that it includes not only God-fearing people, but even those who have deliberately opposed the mission of Christ. They will also see Jesus Christ. Of course, they cannot continue to see Jesus Christ. They will die. But the point is that even the devil will confess that Christ is the Lord, that Jesus is the Lord, and the King of the universe is the creator God, Jesus Christ himself. Even the devil will bow his knee and accept the God that we worship as a God of the universe. Of course, it is not that his heart is changed, but he will see the character of God, and it's displayed in so-called the sky after the millennium and just before God puts an end to sin and suffering in this world. The devil will have the privilege of seeing God and being reminded of the wondrous ways in which God gave opportunities for the people to be saved, but also opportunity for even the devil to know his mistake and confess. Ellen White wrote in the book, Story of Redemption, that Lucifer, before he was thrown down from the heavens, before Lucifer was expelled from the heavens, Ellen White writes that God gave, I mean, the language she uses is that God bore along with him. God bore along with him. It is not simply at one instance that the devil was thrown down from the heavens, but God bore along with him. We understand from even the language of Moses, as he writes in Deuteronomy, that God is long-suffering. God bore along with Lucifer. So as he will see as to how God gave him opportunities, we are told that even he, the devil, will bow to Jesus, meaning accept Jesus Christ, that he is holy and righteous, and that the devil himself was on the wrong. And of course, again, as we said, that is not a conversion or a statement of conviction, a change of heart, but this is, he's forced to do that because he knows that God is the one righteous. And of course, later on, the devil will be destroyed. And God, because he is King of Kings, the righteous will crown him with their eternal praises. Someone said, if you want to praise God the rest of eternity, you need to practice it as we live in this world. The life that we live in this world is only a preparation for the life that is coming for us. Meaning, we just practice a little as to what we will do the rest of eternity. As we live in this world, we practice a little. But the problem, I mean, the assurance is that we will continue to do that. That is praising God forever and ever. We will continue to do that the rest of eternity. And when we stand before his throne, those on earth have claimed the name of Jesus in obedience to him will have his name written on them. The name of Christ, the name of the Creator God, the name of the one that we worship him day in and day out will be written on our foreheads. And again, this is a character of God. God will give us the character of himself. As he made Adam and Eve in God's image, and these people have lost that image, that character, as a sin against God. Praise the Lord. God has already made the arrangement that he will give that character naturally, be grateful to God, naturally to serve him, naturally to enjoy praising him the rest of eternity. Our characters will be changed and we will live with God forever and ever. Praise the Lord that he will give that wonderful opportunity to have the mind of Jesus and the character of Jesus Christ. So talking about the refrain, a powerful refrain indeed, precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. The chorus, the refrain, re-emphasizes the hope and the joy that the name of Jesus can bring. Praise the Lord that we have that name given to us, that we can, yes, experience the joy of heaven even today because of that name of Jesus Christ, joy of heaven. As you go about your daily tasks, you can let Jesus share each concern that comes your way as you take the name of Jesus. What a wonderful opportunity God has given to us. Not only that we know the name of Jesus Christ, but also that love people to know the name of Jesus Christ through us. What is this name of Jesus? All in all. All in all. Name of Jesus. It's healing, it saves, it comforts, it fills our heart with joy, and above all, allows us to live with him forever and ever. Holy and righteous is his name. It is by this name that the disciples performed miracles for God's glory. Remember, as people said, the apostles said, we don't have gold or silver, but what we have is we will give you. What we have, we will give you. And then in the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk. That was not just a miracle for physical transformation, but it was a miracle for heart transformation as well. I just wonder what we would do if this name is not given to us. A name above every name, Jesus Christ. Friends, let's continue to be grateful to God for this wonderful privilege that we have Jesus Christ. We have Jesus Christ and his name to be with us today and forever. God bless us today and every day.
Thank you, Dr. Vara Prasad, for bringing us the very simple and profound truth that the joy of heaven, the joy that we are all looking for, is in the name of Jesus Christ. So take that name with you. We have a great closing song sung in Salisbury Park Adventist Church by a group of men over there called On the Jericho Road. And during the closing prayer, Dr. Vara Prasad, please remember the names that were already mentioned for healing and for strength as they go through this process of recovery.
As you travel along
on the Jericho Road,
on the Jericho Road,
does the world seem all wrong
and heavy your load
just bring it to Christ
your sins all confess
on the Jericho Road
Your heart he will bless
On the Jericho Road
There's room for just two
No more and no less
Just Jesus and you
Each burden he'll bear
Each sorrow he'll share
There's never a care, for Jesus is there.
Oh, Jesus is there.
On the Jericho Road
Blind Bartimaeus sat
His life was a void
So empty and flat
But Jesus appeared
One word brought him sight
On the Jericho Road
Christ banished his night
On the Jericho Road
There's room for just two
No more and no less
Just Jesus and you
Each burden he'll bear
Each sorrow he'll share
There's never a care
For Jesus is there
Oh my brother to you
This message I bring
No hope may be gone
He'll cause you to sing
At Jesus' command
Since shackles must fall
On the Jericho Road
Will you answer his call
On the Jericho Road
There's room for just two
No more and no less
Just Jesus and you
Each burden he'll bear
Each sorrow he'll share
There's never a care
for Jesus is there
On the
On the Jericho Road, there's room for just two.
There's room for just two. No more and no less.
No more and no less. Just Jesus and you.
Just Jesus and you. Each burden he'll bear.
Each burden he'll bear.
Each sorrow he'll share.
Each sorrow he'll share.
There's never a care.
There's never a care. For Jesus is there.
For Jesus is there.
Father in heaven, we thank you for this blessed privilege of calling upon your name on this holy Sabbath. We praise you, Lord, that you are holy and you are righteous. We praise you, Heavenly Father, that even before we utter a word, you know the words that we would speak. We praise you, Heavenly Father, that you not only give us what we ask of you, but you will give us much more than we ask or imagine. We praise you, Heavenly Father, that you fulfill our desires. And Heavenly Father, you bless us in this world in ways that we can be a blessing to one another. So Father, we want to thank you again for the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that Jesus has come down to this world to save us and give us eternal life. Oh Lord, we thank you. This is your arrangement even before sin came into this world. And we want to thank you, Father, in a very special way once again today. May we remain grateful to you for this sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. But also, Father, we want to thank you for the indwelling power of the Holy Spirit. We praise you, Heavenly Father, you are with us and in us, changing us from inside to be like Christ. What a wonderful thing, Heavenly Father, to know that we will have the mind of Jesus and we will have the character of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ written on us, and that we will live the rest of eternity with the mind of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. But also, Father, I want to thank you for the angels who continually watch over us and guard us. We praise you, Heavenly Father, that the angel of the Lord encamps around us, our homes, our institutions, and our churches, that we continue to be blessed, to be a blessing to one another. We praise you, Heavenly Father, for your commitment to bless us and to save us into your eternal life. Thank you so very much, Father. And again, Lord, we want to thank you for the church that we belong to. You have raised this church in these last days, that we experience the greater power of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But also, Father, share that power, share that name, share that joy in Jesus Christ to others as well. So help us, Father, that we continue to depend upon you, call upon you, take the power that you offer to us, that we can share the gospel with others and hasten the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And now, Father, in a very special way, I'd like to pray for Prashant. I also pray for Sugith, and we pray for Mrs. Undru as well. Yes, Father, these are some names that we are mentioning, but all of us have our own problems in life. Heavenly Father, help us that we trust you amidst all kinds of storms in life. Lord, we pray that these three people will feel your presence in a very special way, even as we pray here. That, Lord, you will touch them and give them the assurance that everything is all right. And soon this pain and suffering will end, and that, Lord, we will see you face to face and spend eternity with you in a place where there is no crying, no death, and no temptation, and no pain. Thank you so very much, Father, that you will do this soon. And now, Father, we want to thank you for HopeSide Church and the services that this church is rendering to the community there, but also for the plans they have to reach out to more people than ever before. So, Father, we pray that you will continue to bless the leadership and all the members and their families for your name's honor and glory. May you sanctify the thoughts and the plans that they have for you, that they will continue to rejoice in your goodness, in your leadership, and be a source of joy to others as well. Thank you so very much, Father, once again, for the name of Jesus Christ. May we take it to wherever we go, and may your name alone be glorified. And we pray that this thing will happen the rest of eternity for us. This is our prayer in Jesus' holy name. Amen. May the love of our God and the Father, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the sweet communion and companionship of Holy Spirit abide with us today and forever as we take the name of Jesus Christ wherever we go. Amen and amen.
Amen. Thank you all for joining today. May you have a great weekend and a happy Sabbath. Next week, Mr. Christo Samuel Peter from the Philippines will bring the message. That is on October 28th, Friday. Hope you will join us again. And so at this time, let us meet and greet one another.
Hey, Vara Prasad. Wonderful to see you. Beautiful message. I will never sing that song again without remembering the thought behind it. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. I was blessed as I was reading. All this information is available on the net. Only that I put it in PowerPoint, but I'm blessed by the song and the sentiment of the author. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
Yes, belated happy birthday. When was it?
12, Akka, 12.
Okay. Are you in Pune or are you?
Yes, yes. I'm still in. I'm in Pune still. We have a retreat that is happening from Monday in Ellora. So we'll be going from Pune, and so I'm here again. After this, we will move to. So yes.
Okay.
In the midst of all this, you know, this Prashant thing has come. I had to be in Vellore for some time.
Prashant is your nephew. You said you have a sister, not son.
Anna, say it again.
That is your sister's son?
Yeah, younger sister, Grace's son.
How many sisters do you have?
One older and one younger. I'm a middle child.
Oh, okay. What is the oldest name?
She works in Ellore, that is Ashram Medical College.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, she is a nurse there.
Uh-huh.
Earlier, she was head of the department, whatever department. And then husband, my brother-in-law, became principal of that nursing college. And so they work. Yes, they're doing well by God's grace.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Okay. And the third.
The younger sister is also a nurse.
The next sister after you?
Yeah. This sister was working in Rajahmundry for some time, but this year, June or July, I think July, she started working with a Christian leprosy hospital in Salur, that is close to Vizianagaram.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
They were starting.
Yeah, she is. They were starting a nursing college, and so they invited her to be the principal of that college.
Oh,
they haven't started, but she
belongs to Adventist Church. No.
This is a Christian Mission Hospital where Mr. J.S. Edwards' daughter.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, she's working there along with her husband. The husband is the administrator, she is a dentist there. Yeah, they have invited
Candy,
her.
Candy, so, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Candy, I don't know. The older daughter, yes.
Yeah.
Premila, happy birthday to you too.
Thank you.
How old are we?
I know. That's a question, Auntie. You cannot ask. I believe because, my son says I'm 25.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. If I didn't know you, yeah, 12, Thakka, 12. If I did not tell you earlier, I would have thought that your son is right. I mean, I don't want to say that he's wrong, but that's a blessing. Anyways.
Babu Vara.
Anna, Chapanana.
Nuvu charge this kunava?
Ah, charge this kuna in Nella Indi.
Okay.
September. Yeah, I was moving and my nephew's the problem came and I had to be in the Vellore for some time.
Yeah, Israel son, right?
Part Israel son, yes.
Yeah, how old is he?
He 25. Okay. 25, finished his MBBS, he finished his intern 2 years. And then he was preparing for a need for masters. And that's when this thing came in end of June. Yes, it was discovered. And the doctors said that we can treat that with medication, but nothing helped for 4 months. And he had to undergo surgery. Yeah, it took a toll on all of us. It was an experience of pain.
Sorry about that,
Vara. Yeah. I bet.
Yeah, it's too bad. We will keep praying for him.
Yes, and thank you very much.
Yeah.
They're asked to stay in with 2 more months. So they rented a house and they're there.
Yeah. In Velo.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Velour is not too far from Hosur, is it?
Right. Three and a half hours. So once we move there, we'll be a bit closer.
Definitely. Oh, okay. That's good.
It was good to meet you last Sabbath, dear Sonu.
Yeah. Yeah, it was nice to meet you
but
too.
But we miss, as soon as I saw you, I recognized you from... Oh,
yeah.
The Zoom.
Yeah. It was nice to see you too, Auntie.
But we missed your song. What happened?
We had to go immediately. We were supposed to sing before the Sabbath school lesson.
Uh-huh.
Because Michael had to play in the Tamil church, keyboard in the Tamil church.
Okay.
Mm, so... things didn't happen. We will come again next month.
Yeah, next time.
We should ask Pansy to get you to sing here on this venue.
Yeah, yeah. Sometime, yes. Happy birthday, Dr. Varaprasad. Is it today or this month?
Just a few days ago. Thank you, Dr. Sonia.
Okay. Thank you for your good message as always. It's inspiring. Yeah.
It's always a breath of fresh air.
Yes, it's always nice to have him preach.
Yes.
Happy birthday to Pramilaka as well. She's sweet 16. Ever, yeah.
Oh my goodness. Oh
yes, my that's goodness. The wonderful way of yeah. saying, the best way of saying.
Yeah, no, young at heart. Okay, that I'll agree. But now who knows how the heart is too, right?
Thank you.
No. He's still there. Secunderabad Church.
Oh, Secunderabad Church. I thought.
Yes. Mm-hmm. He's been
there. How are they doing? They're doing well?
Yeah, by God's grace, yes, they're doing well. Thank you so very much.
Yeah, that's very good.